This video tutorial shows you how to submit a National Entry Request, or NER, using MyCIPO Patents. From the home page of MyCIPO Patents, in the New Application tile, click on National Entry Application. If you are authorized to act on behalf of an agent, please select the office and the agent you would like to work on behalf of for the current submission. Enter the PCT application number. Click on the checkbox if the PCT is entering national phase before publication, and click Search. If a PCT number match is found at the World Intellectual Property Office, or WIPO, then the application summary information will be displayed. Review the summary information, and click Apply to proceed. The application is divided into four tabs. It is important to click on the Save button under each tab before proceeding to the next tab, as there is no autosave function. We'll begin with the Details tab, to view the application details. The information available at WIPO will be pre-populated. Update or add information if needed. The Request for Priority table shows all priorities received from WIPO for a published application. When dealing with WIPO received priorities, actions are limited to editing of restoration request and DAS access code. All other corrections, withdrawals or additions of priority claims must be done after the NER submission. We'll briefly go over this towards the end of the video. If applicable, edit the following options on the tab: reference number, correspondence, request for reinstatement of rights, and small entity declaration. Click Save before proceeding to the next tab. Click on the Parties tab to view the application party data. The applicant and inventor information available at WIPO will be pre-populated. Changes to applicants and inventors, from that which is received from WIPO, is limited. Only those applicant changes that were requested at WIPO, but have not yet been processed, can be added or deleted from the applicant's table, with appropriate support documentation. Any changes to applicants or inventors that have not already been requested at WIPO cannot be recorded within the NER filing screens, and must instead be submitted separately after the NER submission. As indicated earlier, we'll come back to this point later in the video. Select a statement of entitlement. To appoint a patent agent, or an associate patent agent, click on the corresponding button, and click Save before proceeding to the next tab. Click on the Documents tab to view and upload documents attached to the application. Any documents you wish to upload must satisfy the technical requirements specified in the information blue box. Select the type of document you wish to upload from the drop-down menu. Note that for new application filings, only those documents strictly tied to the initial filing process are available. To select a file for upload, either click Upload Files, or drag and drop the file in the designated area. Once your document is identified, click Save Document. Repeat the same steps to add more documents. A priority document upload will require an additional input of information, via the Priority drop-down menu, in order to associate it with one of the priority requests previously made on the Details tab. Once uploaded, these will appear in the Priority Documents table. The uploaded documents, except for priority documents, will be listed in the Uploaded Documents table. The status of the uploaded documents will be displayed in the Upload Status columns. To view or delete a document, click on the corresponding button under Action. Any documents available at WIPO are automatically downloaded and attached to the application. They can be viewed in the WIPO Documents table. Note that these documents cannot be deleted. Click on the Fees tab. You have the option of adding the payment of the next maintenance fee due. And you have the option of selecting a general authorization statement. Click Save. The details of the fees are displayed at the bottom of the tab, under Applicable Fees. Once all the tabs have been filled out and the application is ready to be submitted, click Review and Submit in the top right-hand corner of the page. Review the information displayed on the page. Errors detected by the system will be flagged in the red error box at the top of the page. You will need to correct them before the application can be submitted. If the system detects possible omissions in your submission, they will be flagged in a yellow warning box. These warnings are not a barrier to your submission, but correcting them could help ensure a full and complete application. Click Submit and Pay to continue, otherwise click Back if you do not wish to submit, or would like to make changes to your application. Once your application is submitted, from the Submission History tab of the MyCIPO Patents homepage, you may view the corresponding application details, payment receipt, and confirmation of submission. Please note that an application number is generated and assigned to the NER submission. As noted earlier, certain modifications will need to be done after the NER submission. At the initial release of MyCIPO patents, modifications can be submitted using the patent's general correspondence form. Make sure to include the NER application number. Once the portal is fully operational, modifications can be submitted through the Submission on Existing Applications or Patents tile, and by including the application number when requested. For modifications related to priority claims, from the MyCIPO Patents homepage, click on Single Application or Patent, and select the submission type beginning with Priority Modifications. To record changes to applicants or inventors not already requested at WIPO, from the homepage of the portal, click on Single Application or Patent, or on Multiple Applications or Patents, and select the submission type beginning with Correct Applicant or Inventor. Stay tuned for more video tutorials to continue learning about the various functionalities of MyCIPO patents.